Hey guys, I'm the Unknown Gamer, and I found this awesome new game called Guns and Robots. And it's a very well-made game, and it's free and stuff. And here you're gonna build your own robot and try to kill the other guy's robots. And I consider myself fairly good at this game. I mean, if you look at this corner, I've got the Living Apocalypse, which means I've killed every single guy from the opposing team. And to do this, I use this robot right here. And I'm gonna show you how to build him and, well, literally, get the better robot. So I'm gonna show you what I use. So I use, for his bottom part, I used the Bocablus something. You can see it, and well, you know what? I think I'm just gonna go ahead and destroy it, and then show you how it's made. So, first of all, I used this chassis, and it's called the Butch Palace something. And for a motor, I use the heavy duty part. Heavy duty. Now, there's nothing funny about the motor, so I'm gonna apply this something. And for the chassis, I'd use the forge. Now, okay, apply. And the forge, it's a forearms, and it's kind of a heavy body part. And I've used the assault batteries, two assault batteries. So just go ahead and shop that. And for guns, I've used, you just have to buy, for the barrel, or what's it called, or whatever, I recommend you buying three of these, the cannon, so they give you a lot of damage amplified. And you also need to buy one of these, which is the medium, which gives you the most amplified damage. And the guns I would recommend you shopping or buying. That's the Fragnov something. It's the most damaging gun. And I also would recommend you buying the railgun. Now, if I'm gonna go ahead and build my robot, first I'll equip the chassis, then the body, then the head. I recommend you going for the Iron Ranger, because it's a small head, so it's harder to hit. Then I would recommend you go equipping the railgun, the heavy, the four frag nove gun, and there you go. So a little small little test. So the hard thing about this guy is he's slow like fuck, like it's barely moving. So the big thing about him is his damage. This guy is made for damage, but even though he look big, don't fool yourself. He's a very, very easy target because he moves slow and you're a very big target. Therefore, you have to stand behind walls, and when people with low health can't come by, you just go ahead and snipe them. Right? So that's the whole deal with him, actually, but I don't recommend him. I actually recommend this other guy that I have, called, what's it called? I think something, whatever. It's not, it doesn't matter. But this guy is the smallest of them all, literally. And what's he made of is he's made of the chewing gun with this, oh, well, I'll just show you. He's made by the... What's it called? It's called the Archlight. The same that we used for the railgun. So you have to buy one Archlight and one chewing gun. And even though these aren't any damaging things, I mean, look at it, it's like nil damage. And the other guy, if you look at the stats here, and the other guy has like 114 or something. And on the paper, he looks a lot better, except for on the speed. But if you're in a real match, this guy is gonna get you a lot of kills. I'm gonna show you a little bit here on a test. And, well, even though he's just had like 5 damage or something, he can shoot a lot of them and fast. And he's so fast, I mean, if you compare him to the other guy, it's not even a contest on who's faster. And you're very hard to hit because you're so fast, and when you shoot these, you'll just have a lot of explosion in the other opponent's head, and he won't see what's going on. Like, he will be like, what the hell is happening? Because he can only see like this, while you're driving around him, shooting at him. And before you know it, he's dead, you know. And that's the reason why I recommend him. So if you enjoy this, please leave a like and comment and blah 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 blah. So yeah, subscribe. Goodbye.